Paul says that God's power, he says, the immeasurable greatness of his power. Now, we can measure power. Did you know that? What do we call, how do we measure electricity? In watts or kilowatts, right? We can measure electricity, and that's some power. We can measure the power of a hurricane. Category 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can measure it. The destructive force that sweeps across the nations, and all we can do is pray to God. We can't do anything to stop it in ourselves. But we can measure it. We can measure the power of an earthquake that can level cities. We build these cities, and the power of an earthquake can level them, the Richter scale. We can measure it. We can't control it, but we can measure it. We can measure the power of an atomic bomb. What do we measure that with? With megatons. But you know what we can't measure? God's power. God's power is greater than 100 million, trillion, billion, gazillion atomic bombs, hurricanes, earthquakes. Put all together, they're a drop in the ocean compared to God's power. God's power. And it says that God used that power when he raised Christ from the dead and seated Christ in heavenly places above everything. And that same power that raised Christ from the dead, the Bible says, is alive inside of you. Today.